Mrs. Eliza Jean-Reed, thank you so much for allowing us to have some questions to you. You are the first lady of Iceland, which has so much to say in terms of women's rights. So it's a privilege to have you here for International Women's Rights Day.
Thank you. Thanks very much for inviting me to say a few words with you.
So my first question will be, of course, about the use of this International Women's Rights Day.
Well, I think, you know, International Women's Day is a very important day just to remind us all that the fight for gender equality is still ongoing, maybe especially to remind those of us in countries where we've achieved a fairly high level of equality that, you know, good enough is not quite good enough. And to remind us all as well that even though here on International Women's Day, we are celebrating women and their contributions to the world, working towards greater gender equality is something that is going to benefit people of all genders. And so as we work forward in this, in these objectives, this is something that's going to be better for everybody in our societies.
As a first lady, could you tell us what do you do in terms of implementation for women's rights?
You know, I think a lot about this question because there's kind of an irony there. I have a platform. More people listen to me because I serve as First Lady of Iceland, which isn't even, you know, an official job. And I have this platform because of something my husband achieved. He was elected president of the country. And when he was first elected in 2016, I thought that this was all a bit ironic. I thought I can't talk about gender equality, one of the areas that I'm most passionate about, because I didn't earn this platform myself. My husband earned a platform that I'm kind of tagging along with. But I think that it shows you in life, we get different opportunities. We get different moments when maybe more people are listening to us or not, and that we all have a voice that we need to be using. And we need to hear women's voices more, not less. And so I decided that regardless of how it was that I got this platform, I have the opportunity either now to use it or to squander it. And so for me, it's one of the things that I focus on a lot as a woman, excuse me, married to the head of state of Iceland, to use my voice to show people that I am not just some kind of accessory for what he is doing, that I have my own ideas and my own voice. And to add a kind of broader dimension to that, specifically in Iceland, you hear that I'm speaking with an accent. English is my first language because I was born and raised in Canada. And so when I speak Icelandic, which is my third language, I speak with an accent and I make mistakes. And I also think that's important for people to see, for people to know that we have all kinds of voices. They're all different. And it shouldn't limit us to the areas and the topics that we're allowed to talk about. So the idea of gender equality and the idea of this subtle sort of messaging that we bring across is really pervasive throughout what I do and what I say as First Lady.
The topic of United Nations this year for women, International Women's Rights Day, is dealing with this notion of investment in favor of women, especially replacing women's rights into human rights. How do you implement that in your approach?
Well, you know, as you said, it was a former First Lady, Hillary Rodham Clinton, who said first in 1995 that women's rights are human rights. And I think that's very important and plays off that message of the fact that working towards greater equality benefits people of all genders. So that's something that I also try to discuss a lot, you know, when I talk about these issues. This isn't a zero-sum game. This isn't about something where we're taking something away from one group and giving it to another group. It's elevating the playing field for everybody, evening out the opportunities for everybody. And I'm really excited that I will be in New York this year, just after International Women's Day, for the Commission on the Status of Women to do some sideline events to talk as well about what we're doing in Iceland, because here in Iceland we have not closed our gender gap, but we are according to the World Economic Forum the number one country that is closest to closing it. And I think that perhaps the biggest reason for that is that we've realized that This is a conscious decision that we have to be working constantly towards. It's not something that just happens by itself. But we also know that because it's going to benefit everybody, we've kind of moved past the tipping point of debating whether or not working towards greater equality is an important goal, but how we are going to get there.
Could you give us a specific anecdote, you know, of, you know, your career dealing with women's rights?
Yes. I talk a lot about Iceland and the laws and the legislation that we've passed, but I suppose my biggest example is how I try to serve in my role as a spouse for the head of state of Iceland, which I really try to do by using my voice and a little bit confounding expectations about what the female spouse of a male head of state is meant to do. For instance, I've always had my regular job since I've been serving as First Lady. I run a writer's retreat. I work sort of as a spokesperson with Business Iceland and talk about sustainable travel and tourism and investment. And I also wrote a book, which you can see behind me actually, all about the women of Iceland. And part of that project for me was also elaborating on my own experience as a journalist. So developing myself professionally, which is important, but also profiling the stories of dozens of Icelandic women who aren't necessarily the leaders in their fields or the first to do something, but regular women. And the idea behind that is to inspire all of us to know that we are all role models and we can all have a positive role to play in this. It's not enough to say, I elect officials who will enact laws that will help this, or I will leave that to other people, but really that we can apply this egalitarian approach to all facets of our life. And so I hope the stories of the women I tell in the book both introduce people a little bit to my adopted homeland of Iceland. It's kind of a love letter to Iceland, but in a way through this country's women, so that we can learn a bit about what it's like to be a farmer or a mayor or a mother or an entrepreneur or a poet, et cetera, in the world's best country for women.
Coming from another country than Iceland, what would you say is, I know that there are many, but is the best genius idea concerning equality that Iceland have compared to other European countries, for example?
Well, I like to say that we don't have a patent or a recipe that makes Iceland better, you know, why it sort of happened. But I think one of the biggest things is this idea that I hope that, broadly speaking, as a society, I hope that we recognize that this is something that benefits everybody. And so everybody should be invested in it in some way. And it's great that we have debates and dialogue about what to prioritize and where we should be going. And that's very healthy in a democracy. But I think that people aren't arguing that this is not an important priority. And I think that people recognize that we aren't there yet, that even though we have narrowed the gap in many areas, we haven't closed the gap at all. And therefore we need to keep continuing that the good status that we have achieved is not good enough yet.
To finish, what would be an advice or maybe a message, inspirational message that you would like to give us for International Women's Rights Day?
Well, my advice would really be just to remember that we are all role models, that we all have an impact on the environment around us, and that impact ripples on to a greater area. So it's not enough to say, I can't make a difference, because we can all make a difference. And it's up to us to choose whether we want to be positive or negative role models. I choose to be positive, and I hope everybody else does too.
Thank you. Thank you for giving us so much positivity here for International Women's Rights Day. We will follow your example. We wish you good luck, and thank you. Thank you again for being with us today.
Thank you so much. Have a lovely day. Thank you. One more.